गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय क्लास अगेन. दिस इज माय फोर्थ क्लास विच आई एम गोइंग टू टेक टुडे. इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्रीवियस क्लासेस दैट आई हैव टेकन, दैट क्लास नंबर 1, 2 एंड 3, इन द फर्स्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, द स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म, एंड वी हैव टेकन सम एग्जाम्पल्स एंड वी हैव कन्वर्टेड दैट एग्जाम्पल्स इन टू क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. Right. In the second class, we have discussed about the method of solving quadratic equation, and we have generally focused on two method, that are splitting the middle term method, and the second one is formula method. And we have also solved some questions on quadratic equation. In third class, we are focused on the homework which I have given in class number 1 and 2. And in third class, I have given one assignment also. In this class, I am going to solve that assignment. And I want to discuss some more questions which are very, very important and which are many a time coming in the examination. Right? So let's start this class with the solution of the assignment that I was given in the third class. Okay, the assignment that I was given in the third class, the questions are as follows. The first question is, if the sum of first n even natural numbers is 420, then find the value of n. In this question, we have given the first n even natural number, and if we add that even number, we will get 420. So before solving this question, first of all, we have to clear about even number. The even number are the numbers that are divisible by 2. Therefore, the first even number is 2, and next to that are 4, 6, 8, etc. While observing the even numbers, if we see, new topic is also introduced here, that is arithmetic progression, and that is chapter number 5. We have to know something about arithmetic progression also while solving this question. Okay, arithmetic progressions are the set of numbers or number series which follow a pattern. In that pattern, they have a common difference. That means if you subtract any two consecutive terms, the difference are same only. Here in arithmetic progression, the first number are said to be A, and the difference between the numbers are said to be D, and the formula given by sum of numbers, formula for finding sum of numbers is given by Sn, and that is equals to n by 2 in the bracket 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, let's start this question. Even numbers form a AP. We can write it as 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. Here the first term is 2 and that is A, and the common difference is 2. First term is 2, common difference is 2, and summation of n terms are given, that is 420, that is given in the question, right? Now we have discussed about the formula also, that is Sn is n by 2 in the bracket 2a plus n minus 1 into d. That means if you substitute the value, we can write 420 equals to n by 2 in the bracket 4 plus 2n minus 2. And if you simplify this one, we will get a quadratic equation, that is n square plus n minus 420 equals to 0. And if you solve this quadratic equation by any one of the method, you can apply a formula method also, you can apply splitting the middle term also. Here I have I applied the middle term, splitting the middle term method. We can split n as 21n minus 20n. Okay, and if we group the terms, and on solving we will get n plus 21 and n minus 20 as two factors. If we equals to n plus 21 plus n minus 20 equals to 0, that means n plus 21 equals to 0 and n minus 20 equals to 0. If we take n plus 21 equals to 0, then n equals to minus 21. That is not possible because the number of terms can't be minus 21. So the value of n is 20. Okay, is it clear to you? Moving to the next question, that is question number 2 of the assignment. The question is, very good question. If you Read the question. It is looking like that it is a very hard question, but if you understand the question, it will be very easy to solve this one. What is the problem with the students? Many students are not reading the question, they are just thinking about the solution. Students, whenever you are solving the word problem, first of all, you have to read question carefully. If you read the question carefully, then automatically you will get 50 to 60% things in the question only. You have to just do 20 to 30%. Okay. If you read this question, here it is written that while boarding an aeroplane, a passenger got hurt. Here the aeroplane was going to be board, and due to some technical error or due to any problem, a passenger got hurt. The pilot, showing promptness and concern, made arrangements and hospitalized the injured so that the plane started late by 30 minutes. Right? Due to this, the plane started 30 minutes late. Therefore, the pilot increases the speed of the plane by 100 km per hour. And the destination was 15 km away. You have to find the speed, initial speed, that means original speed in kilometer per hour. Right? Here the distance of the destination is given. Total distance is 1500 km. So let the initial speed be V kilometer per hour. You can take any variable. I have taken here V. The initial speed is V kilometer per hour, and due to that incident, the pilot increased the speed by 100 km. Therefore, the new speed will be what? Very clear, V plus 100 km per hour. The initial time taken by the plane to reach the destination. Time equals to what? Distance upon speed. As speed equals to distance upon time, therefore time equals to distance upon speed. Therefore, time 1, that means initially the time taken by the plane will be 1500 upon V. But here the new time equals to T2, and that is equals to 1500 upon V plus 100, and the difference between the time is 30 minutes, right? 30 minutes means what? 1 by 2 hour. Therefore, if we subtract 1500 upon V plus 100 from 1500 upon V, we will get 1 by 2. Or you can write 1500 upon V equals to 1500 upon V plus 100 plus 1 by 2, right? Because there is a time gap of half an hour. 30 minutes means half an hour. Therefore, we can write 1500 upon V equals to 1500 upon V plus 100 plus 1 by 2. So on solving this one, you will get, first of all, if you solve this one, you will get a quadratic equation, and on solving that equation, you will get V equals to minus 600 and V equals to 500. So V equals to minus 600 is not possible. Why? Because the speed can't be negative. Therefore, the speed of the plane be 500 km per hour. I think it is very clear to you. Right? Next one, that is question number 3. This question says that a person wishes to fit 3 rods together. A person has 3 rods and he wants to fit these 3 rods in the form of right angle triangle, and it is given that the hypotenuse is 4 cm longer than its base and 8 cm longer than its altitude. Okay. He has 3 rods and he wants to fit in a right angle triangle such that the hypotenuse, the longest side of a right angle triangle, is 4 cm longer than its base and 8 cm longer than its altitude. Right? So let the base be x, therefore the perpendicular be x minus 4 and the hypotenuse is x plus 4. Here x plus 8 is wrong. Okay, ignore it. At the place of x plus 8, you have to take x plus 4. Right? The perpendicular is x minus 4 and the hypotenuse is x plus 4. Okay. Now we know the Pythagoras theorem. As it is given a right angle triangle, we can have a Pythagoras theorem. As per the Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse whole square equals to perpendicular square plus base square. Therefore, at the place of hypotenuse, we have x plus 4 whole square. At the place of perpendicular, we have to write x minus 4 whole square. And at the place of base square, we have to write x square. If we expand x plus 4 square, we are going to use a plus b whole square formula. Therefore, it is equals to x square plus 16 plus 8x. And while expanding x minus 4 whole square, we are using a minus b whole square. That is equals to a square minus 2ab. So, minus 2ab plus b square. And if we simplify, we will get x equals to 16. Therefore, the value of x is 16. That means the base is 16 and the hypotenuse is how much? X plus 4, that means 20. And the perpendicular is x minus 4, that means 16 minus 4, that is 12. Got it? Moving to the next question. That is solution number 4. Very important question. Many times it is asked in MCQ also, and you have studied this type of question in standard 8 also. Okay, time and work, if you remember that one. A takes 10 days less than time taken by B to finish the piece of work. If both A and B work together, they finish the work in 12 days, then time taken by B to finish the work is. Okay, here it is given that A takes 10 days less than B. And if they work together, they can complete the work in 12 days. And you have to find the time to complete the work by B. Here it is asked to find the time taken by B to complete the work. So first of all, suppose the time taken by B to complete the work be X days. It is very clear. A will take 10 days less than B. If B take X days, then A will take X minus 10 days. Clear? If B complete the whole work in X days, that means they can complete 1 by X part of the total work in 1 day, right? Similarly, if A alone can finish the work in X minus 10 days, that means in 1 day, he can complete 1 upon x minus 10 work, 10 part of the work, right? And if they work together, they will complete in 12 days, right? That means A plus B 1 day work equals to 1 by 12. See, B take x day to complete the whole job. Therefore, the amount of work done in 1 day will be equals to A complete the whole job in x minus 10 day. That means he can do 1 upon x minus 10 part of the work in 1 day. And if they both work together, they are going to complete the whole work in 12 days. That means if they are working together, they can complete 1 upon 12 part of work in 1 day. Right. Now, A's work plus B's work. A's 1 day work plus B's 1 day work equals to A plus B 1 day work. That is clear. We can write it as A's 1 day work plus B's 1 day work. See, A's 1 day work plus B's 1 day work equals to A plus B 1 day work. And A plus B 1 day work is 1 by 12. A's 1 day work is what? 1 upon x minus 10. B's 1 day work is 1 upon x equals to 1 by 12. And if you simplify this one, you will get a quadratic equation at the last. If you simplify this one, you will get x square minus 34x plus 120 equals to 0 as a quadratic equation. And if you solve this quadratic equation by any one of the method, you will get x equals to 4 or x equals to 30. But x equals to 4 is not possible. Why? Because if you take x equals to 4, then A alone can finish the work in 4 minus 10, that is minus 6 day. How can anyone complete the work in minus 6 day? That means it is not possible. Therefore, the amount of days in which A can finish the work is 30 day. Got it? Okay. That's all for all the solution of assignment. Now we are going to take some extra questions also. Some extra questions in this one. The first question is, If minus 5 is the root of a quadratic equation 2x square plus px minus 15 equals to 0, and a quadratic equation p in the bracket x square plus x plus k equals to 0 has equal roots, find the value of k. So here there are two parts of the question. In first part, it is given that minus 5 is the root of a quadratic equation 2x square plus px minus 15 equals to 0. That means if we substitute minus 5 at the place of x in the first equation, it satisfies the equation, right? Let's substitute the value of x in the first equation. So you can write 2 into minus 5 whole square plus p into minus 5 minus 15 equals to 0. And if you simplify this one, you will get the value of p as 7, right? While solving the first equation, we are able to find the value of p. Now we are focusing on the second. In the second case, the equation is p into x square plus x plus k equals to 0. If you substitute the value of p here as 7, because we have already find the value of p, right? We have already find the value of p while substituting the value of x in the first case, right? The second equation can be written as 7 into x square plus x plus k equals to 0, right? If you open the bracket, 7 will be multiplied by this x square also, and this 7 will be multiplied by x also. So this can be further written as 7x square plus 7x plus k equals to 0, right? And it is given in the questions that second equation has equal roots, right? They have equal roots. That means the discriminant equals to 0. Discriminant means b square minus 4ac equals to 0. And if we compare 7x square plus 7x plus k by standard form of quadratic equation, the value of a is 7, the value of b is 7, and the value of c is k. While substituting the value, we will get the value of k as 7 by 4. Hope this one is very clear to all of you. Okay, now move to the next question. Very important question. It is coming in the examination for 4 marks. See the question. The question is looking, if we observe the question, it is looking very hard. Okay, but if you understand this question, this is very easy. If you observe the question here, you have to solve this question. That means you have to find the value of x. The question is x square in the bracket a upon a plus b plus a plus b upon a into x plus 1. Right, if you observe the middle term only, in the middle term in the bracket there is a upon a plus b plus a plus b upon a. Both the values are reciprocal of each other. Observe it. Both the values are reciprocal of each other. That means if you multiply both, the answer will be 1. Right? A upon a plus b into a plus b upon a equals what? A plus b cancel out, and a and a are cancel out. That means a upon a plus b into a plus b upon a equals to 1. At the place of 1, we can write a upon a plus b plus a plus b upon a. Okay. So just substitute 1 as a upon a plus b into a plus b upon a. Right? See, at the place of 1, we have written a upon a plus b and a plus b upon a. Correct? Now just open the bracket. As we open the bracket, second term bracket, this x will be multiplied by this a upon a plus b and a plus b upon a, both. This expression further expressed as x square plus a upon a plus b into x plus a plus b upon a into x plus a upon a plus b into a plus b upon a. Clear? Now if you observe the first and second term, what is common there? In first and second term, x is common, right? In first and second term, x is common. If we take it out, inside there will be x at the first term plus x is going out. Therefore, inside there will be a upon a plus b. In third and fourth term, a plus b upon a is common. If we are taking it out, inside there will be x plus a upon a plus b. Now, if you observe the expression, x plus a upon a plus b will be common. If we take out x plus a upon a plus b, inside there will be x plus a plus b upon a equals to 0. That means x plus a upon a plus b equals to 0, or x plus a plus b upon a equals to 0. Therefore, the value of x is either minus a upon a plus b or x equals to minus a plus b upon a. Understood? This is a very good question. Many times it is coming in the examination. Okay. Moving to the next one. This one is also an important question. This is also coming many times in the examination. If the roots of the quadratic equation a minus b x square plus b minus c x plus c minus a equals to 0 are equal, roots are equal, right? That means roots are equal means the value of d is 0. That means b square minus 4ac equals to 0. Then you have to prove that 2a equals to b plus c. See? Here the, if we compare the given equation with a quadratic equation, here the value of a is a minus b, the value of b is b plus c, and the value of c is c minus a. The discriminant is 0, that means the value of d is 0. D is 0 means b square minus 4ac is 0. Substitute the value of a, b and c here. So it can be written as b minus c whole square minus 4 into a minus b into c minus a equals to 0. And if we open this bracket, first bracket, b minus c whole square, it can be written as b square minus 2bc plus c square. Now if you multiply a minus b and c minus a, it is equals to ac minus a square minus bc plus ab. Now if we further simplify this one, you will get finally 4a square plus b square plus c square minus 4ab plus 2bc minus 4ac. Now if you remember chapter number 2 class 9th polynomial, there was a identity, that is a plus b plus c whole square, and the formula of that one is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ac. So here we are going to apply that one. That means 4a square plus b square plus c square minus 4ab plus 2bc minus 4ac can be written as 2a minus b minus c whole square. That means 2ab minus b minus c equals to square root of 0, and square root of 0 is nothing but it is 0 only. Okay, now if we take this minus b and minus 2 that side, then it will be written as 2a equals to b plus c. That is what we want to prove. Got it? This is also very important questions. Many times it is coming in the examination. Okay, again we have an important question. Express x in terms of a, b and c. Very important questions. Okay, while solving this one, we have to first of all observe the expression. It is a upon x minus a plus b upon x minus b equals to 2c upon x minus c. If we solve the left hand side, then the LCM of x minus a and x minus b is x minus a into x minus b. That a will be multiplied by x minus b and b will be multiplied by x minus a equals to 2c upon x minus c. If you simplify this one, you will get ax square plus bx square minus 2abx minus acx minus bcx plus 2ab equals to 2c square minus 2acx minus 2bcx plus 2abc. And if you further simplify this one, you will get a plus b minus 2c whole bracket then x square plus ac plus bc minus 2ab whole bracket x equals to 0. In both term we observe x as common. Therefore if we are taking out x as common, inside there will be a plus b minus 2c x plus ac plus bc minus 2ab equals to 0. That means either x equals to 0 or a plus b minus 2c x plus ac plus bc minus 2ab equals to 0. Therefore x equals to 2ab minus ac minus bc upon a plus b minus 2c. Okay, therefore the value of x is either 0 or the value of x is either 2ab minus ac minus bc upon a plus b minus c. Hope you enjoy all the questions. All the questions are the important questions that are coming in the examination. Many times it has come also. Okay, this is all about today's class. Now write some question for homework. I have given some question for homework. Okay, write it in your notebook and try to solve from home. Okay, I am giving 30 seconds for writing this one. Just write it. And thank you very much. Okay, I hope you have written all this question. Thank you very much.